Well, 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 look where we are again. Hey there, guys, it's your buddy Bulldozer Man, and, well, looks like it's time for another tier list. Today, we are rating MMORPGs. As you can see down here, we got a lot of them to go through, from RuneScape, from RuneScape to Genshin Impact and everything that came out in between. Now, I should probably mention that I'm only going to be rating games that I myself have played and actually have some semblance of experience with. So if you don't see your favorite, game here, then that means I probably haven't played it or haven't played it enough to have a solid opinion about it. So, yeah. So, I say with all that said, let's get to it. First and foremost, the first MMO that I've ever played. And, you know, I'm just going to do some of these, like out of order, because there's some I want to get, like, out of the way right away. First on the lineup, Disney's Toontown Online. What needs to be said about this game? It came out in 2003. It pretty much pioneered the child-friendly, MMORPG as we know them. I'm pretty sure that some of these games like Wizard 101 would not exist were it not for Toontown. So, yep. Yeah, I mean, this game did have its downsides. I mean, you had to pay for a subscription to play past Toontown Central. The game stopped, receiving updates in its last few years of life. And these days, you can't even play this version of the game anymore. So, it has its faults, but it is a cult classic. I think there's a reason why two of its fan-made remakes are down here. You know, Disney may have shut it down, but it's still alive and kicking today, so... Yeah, I'm thinking rock-solid A-tier to start things off. Yeah, because Toontown is an OG, and it definitely deserves some major recognition. Toontown Rewritten, the first fan-made revival of Toontown. This game was mostly faithful to Toontown Online, but it's made a lot of changes recently and added a lot of new stuff that is, unique to it. I mean, there's the brand new field offices, there's some new boss fights on the way, the damage values, the gags, cog attacks, cog health, all that stuff has been changed. So yeah, there's a lot to look forward to in this version of the game. That said, I'm not prepared to drop this game into S tier for one reason. The trolley mini games cannot be skipped, which, let me tell you what, when you're trying to do those trolley games for the cellbot, field office tune resistance task is a goddamn chore, and you have to sit through half an hour of trolley games just to do one step of one tune task. That little change alone pretty much knocked me out of playing this game entirely, because I don't care for the stupid trolley games. The amount of jelly beans you get for doing them is pure garbage. Especially once you're up to, 100 laugh, and just go out and take out, 100 cogs in, 20 minutes and get, 1,200 beans that way. So, yeah. For all the positives that Toontown, Rewritten has brought, it definitely fumbled the bag in a couple of places, and for that reason, It's getting an A tier. If this game would just allow you to skip the trolley games and also grinding for all, like lap points in the optional, side activities can also be quite a chore. So I think if those two problems with the game were fixed, I'd be more than willing to bump this to S tier, but it's downsides. They keep it down to A tier. Toontown Corporate Clash. This game is a bona fide slapper. It pretty much took what worked with the other two Toontown games, took out what didn't work, and multiplied the results by 10. This game kicks ass. It's like a brand new game. It feels like a proper, game compared to what these two were. It has so much new content in it, like new kinds of Lawbots, a fifth cog corporate ladder, some brand new boss fights, even hard mode variants of the boss fights, new normal cogs who act as special boss encounters that you can that you have to fight, and probably the big thing, you don't have to grind all the side activities to get all the trophies to get all, to get every single lap boost. You just have to play them enough until you max out your level and the game just, and the game just hands you those lap points. So, yeah. Toontown Corporate Clash. This game is awesome. If I were to go back to a version of Toontown today, it will probably be Corporate Clash. And maybe rewritten if Corporate Clash is down for some reason. So, yep, Toontown CC, you get an S tier. So you are awesome. All right, now that the Toontown games are done and over with, let's take a look at some of these other ones down here. Oh, The Lord of the Rings Online. I gotta be honest, I played this game a lot a few years ago, but over time it kind of just, fell off my list. From what I understand, the game is still going darn well these days with new expansions and whatnot, and the fact that they're allowing, VIP players to actually play, like the later game worlds without having to buy them. Which is a pretty big deal, because those later expansions are like 30, 40 bucks a piece. There's a lot of them now, so that's a lot of cash to ask of people nowadays. So yeah, they definitely made a smart choice there. That being said, the game does have a few faults. The engine is a little outdated nowadays. While the game runs okay, it can still stutter every once in a while, I sometimes do. But the main thing that brings this game down for me is the grind to get fully equipped. Oh my goodness, where do I even start? You have to grind equipment, you have to grind little thingamajiggers, I think they're essences to put inside of your equipment. Or you can just craft your equipment, but that takes an ungodly amount of time. You have to grind, a whole mess of equipment at that, because you've got a lot of slots to fill out on your character. You've got to grind Slayer deeds and whatnot to get all your traits, and yeah, the late game grind in this game, I'm just gonna be blunt with you, it makes the grind in Genshin Impact or Final Fantasy 14 look like child's play by comparison. So it could be a lot to ask of lots of people, and folks like me, we just don't have enough time to, devote to this game to make the grind. So Yeah. I'm thinking Lord of the Rings Online. You're an awesome game. One that I would definitely consider, you know, replaying, you know, once the money's right, but because of how tedious that grind can be, you're going in A tier. Also, the mounted combat in this game was a nice idea on paper, but it kind of falls off in the later games, so yeah. Oh boy. I think you guys know what I think of Wizard 101 by now, and the company that created it. My personal bias aside, this game is really starting to show its age. I mean, the engine it was made on was made in 1998, and to my knowledge, they still haven't updated it. So the performance, even on decent, you know, even on decent to high-end PCs, can really be a pain in the ass sometimes. The combat is so repetitive that I never want to play this game past level 60, because pretty much once you get your first AoE, it's just blade, AoE. That's basically all you do for like 95% of the entire game. Presentation-wise, it gets better toward the end, but for that first 70%, it can be a little rough around the edges with how it presents its story. You know, like the story presentation in this one really struggles to hold up compared to something like Final Fantasy XIV. So, and let's not even mention the fact that the paywall is only at level 7 when the level cap is like 170. Wizard 101, there's a reason Final Fantasy XIV lets people play for free up to the latest expansion, because 7 levels is not enough for people to decide if a game's worth the money or not. You guys really should know this by now. This game pushes the microtransactions pretty heavily with all the lore packs and whatnot. Basically, you know, loot boxes. I think a lot of us hate those things, so yeah, loot boxes are straight up banned in some countries, so that alone should tell you a lot of, you know, how, you know, what people think of them, so yeah. And plus the late game grind to get fully geared up. It's not quite on Lord of the Rings level, but it's starting to get pretty close. It's getting a little concerning, so yeah. Wizard 101, I will definitely respect this game's legacy. I mean, I played the shit out of this game back in its heyday, but nowadays, it's just a shell of its former self, and it's really struggling to stay, you know, it's really struggling to stay somewhat relevant nowadays, so B tier for that one. It can still be a fun time, but its faults are just too numerous, just too expansive to ignore. And on a similar subject, I believe Pirate 101 to be the superior of the two games, because number one, it's not as long as Wizard 101. You can comfortably like beat this like in like a month or two. Number two, it's not littered with so much freaking side activity nonsense that's constantly, you know, yanking your attention away from the main story. Number three, well, it's not as bad, with the microtransactions, so yeah, there is that. There isn't nearly as many of those lore packs with the overpowered equipment as is in a wizard. Number four, the characters are a lot more, you know, consistent in this game, seeing as a lot of them are your characters, the crewmates who, you know, fight alongside you in the story. So, you know, this game can actually take some time to flesh out more than 10% of its cast. Like, The only characters that are properly fleshed out in Wizard are... I'm struggling to think of anybody. I think Merle Ambrose, a couple of the professors, and that's basically it. The game moves along so fast that it doesn't have time to flesh out like anybody else. So really, aside from some of the people you meet in the first half hour, nobody in Wizard is really all that memorable. Whereas in Pirate 101, a lot of these guys stick with you from start to finish, so this game has a lot of time to flesh them all out. A lot of them do undergo some noteworthy character growth as the game goes on. So, and on top of that, the story of this game is a lot more interesting. So, yeah. And plus the combat in Pirate is not nearly as mindless and brain dead as Wizard. This game actually forces you to stop and plan out, you know, your approach with every encounter. So, because it's a lot like Fire Emblem. It's a big chessboard with all the units on it. So, yeah, Pirate. This game, if I had to pick a King's Isle game to revisit nowadays, which won't be very often for obvious reasons, but I'll probably pick Pirate over Wizard. Simply because it's not full of nearly as much bullshit as Wizard is, so... Pirate, you get an A tier. Much deserving, so... I think this game's only drawback is that nowadays it doesn't get a lot of updates anymore. No, mobile gaming really kicked this game... Like, right square in... Let the nuts. King's Isle seems to be mostly... focusing on Wizard nowadays, so you might be waiting a little while for some Pirate updates. Adventure Quest 3D. This game is nice. Playing on PC or on mobile, the classes are all you know, a lot of fun to play, and you know, it does have a pretty fascinating story. You're basically Carpenter of Death in this game, quite literally. So, yeah, this game's a fun time. The only problem is it's pretty obscure nowadays, and not something you'll hear in a lot of discussions about the best online game to play these days. Nowadays, you'll probably hear Final Fantasy XIV, WoW, maybe Wizard if you're lucky, but this game, not so much. So, it's pretty out there, it's pretty obscure, but overall, it's still a fun time, so, yeah. I'm picking a B tier for that one. Obviously, I haven't spent as much time with it as some of these other games, so... Yeah, maybe if I spent more time with it, it might get an A tier, but on the flip side, if I spent more time with it, I might find a few more problems that, might knock it down a C, so... I think it'd be best to compromise for a B tier. Oh my god, this game. Age of Conan Unchained. This game sucks. Like, I think it looks somewhat pretty at least. Like don't get me wrong, for the year it came out, it was a pretty nice looking game, but where do I start with its problems? Number one, it's old. Like, really old. It's probably not gonna be around for too much longer. Number two, it's difficult. Like, I don't know who on earth decided this game should be the Dark Souls of the MMO world, but this game is just brutal, especially if you're going solo. And like, I know that's supposed to be the whole point of, Conan the Barbarian, that it's a brutal world, but come on, did that really need to translate to the game? God. And from what I hear, Conan Exiles ain't much better in that department, so But I haven't played that game, so it's not on the list, obviously, but man, this game's just hard. Hard. And you know what? Number three, what is up with the performance in this game? Like, even on a pretty good high-end PC, this game is bound to start lagging or, you know, have some slowdown every once in a while. Like, ugh. Really? That's the best they could do? Yeah. I'm sorry, guys, but this game just ain't it. You know, because of its age, there's not a lot of people playing it nowadays, so yeah. You know what? I think being able to build your own town like wherever you want was a nice idea, but a lot of people are just probably gonna end up dumping this game long before, you know, they can even get to that point, so yeah. I could definitely, you know, respect this game for trying to, you know, shake things up and maybe, you know, offer something unique compared to a standard game, but I think this game just changes a little too much too fast. Paired up with that borderline extreme difficulty. Yeah, I'm sorry. I can't defend this game whatsoever. Ugh. Get in the bin. Freaking Age of Conan Unchained. More like Age of Conan wasted my fucking time. Alright. Abbabelle Online. I played this game a lot, you know, way back when, back before I had my own PC. I was mostly on mobile back then, so I was just looking for a good, you know, MMO to spend my time on. And this one was okay. And I think today it is still worth revisiting. For morbid curiosity, if nothing else, but ugh. I think nowadays, you know, online games on mobile they look a lot better than this game. This game's classes leave something to be desired, like, I don't know, maybe I'm just biased or have been spoiled by other games or something, but something about the class in this game just rubbed me like the wrong way. Not to mention the fact that they closed the in-game bazaar/marketplace in this game, which was a really bad move, Asabimo. That's one of the main reasons people play these games, so they can use the market board to get themselves geared up. But, you know, when you take that away, it kind of just wrecks the experience, so yeah, I don't know what they were thinking with that one, but Abbabelle Online, it's kind of fallen off, you know. It's kind of fallen off as of late, so yeah, I'm thinking C tier because of how good it was back in its heyday, but nowadays, yeah, there's much better to play. Irunia Online. I haven't really played this one all that much, and from what I've seen, it's not that good nowadays. I mean, I get that it still has a really active community, and it's still somewhat relevant nowadays, you know, being a prequel to Torum Online, but which is arguably the more popular game, but well, this one looks to be in the same boat as Abbabelle. It's overshadowed by Asabimo's new games. I get that it's still being updated, but it feels like this game is just like, you know, it's just like grasping for life at this point. You know, especially compared to some of those new games, so Yeah. And plus, in the same page as Adderall, some of the classes in this game just rub me, you know, but the wrong way, so... I'm thinking, I'm having trouble deciding between C and D tier for this one. I'm thinking this game deserves a D because it was okay back when it first came out, but nowadays, especially with the sequel out, there's not a whole lot of reason to, you know, I'll go back to it nowadays. Torm Online. This game is still a slapper nowadays. I mean, obviously I'll, you know, revisit other games, you know, over this one, since Asabimo can't really decide on what they want to do with it anymore. Have you guys even played the end game in this game? It's like, jeez, what's the point? You know what? What's the point of having this? We can have like tons of HP if you're just gonna have everything do tons of fractional damage that just two-shot everybody, even the tanks. So yeah, I mean, Torm Online, being able to pretty much design your own like class in this game with the various skills and whatnot, it's still a pretty good game, and it even does have some funny, you know, bits in the story, especially concerning Palulu. But I don't know, it seems like a lot of days this game just struggles to, you know, stay somewhat relevant. Especially on PC with games like, you know, with games like Final Fantasy 14 out and about. And on mobile, games like Genshin Impact are just absolutely kicking Torm's ass, so yeah. I know some people probably won't be happy with me shitting on Torm, but I think these days it's still a solid play, but other games simply do everything better. While the late game grind... Okay, yeah, you know what? The late game grind in this game sucks. You've got to grind so much money to finish off your builds. By the time you do that, like the next expansion's probably dropped. Now you gotta scramble to get yourself re-equipped. Yeah, and this game abuses the microtransactions pretty heavily. Like, you pretty much have to dump like $30 in this game if you want to unlock the 2 slots on all your gear, which seems pretty cheap. So, game's still fun. It's still a good time, but I'm thinking a B tier for that one, but no higher or no lower. It's still fun enough to keep it out of the lower tiers, but its faults definitely keep it from the higher tiers. It's still good, but other games simply do things better. Final Fantasy 11. I thought this game was okay, and apparently it's still okay to play nowadays. Yeah, from what I've seen online, there's still a devoted fan base who still plays this game somewhat. What's what I'm looking for? It's still somewhat relevant because of its fan base. Obviously, there's not much reason to, you know, go back to it nowadays, you know, because the sequel is so much better. But yeah, I think Final Fantasy 11, it can still be a fun time. It is a little antiquated nowadays, you know, compared to its sequel and compared to other games that have come out since. But yeah, I'm thinking a B tier for that one. It's still a fun time, but it is somewhat old. It's in the same boat as Wizard in that regard. It's old, and there's other games out that do things much better, so there's not much point to revisit it these days. But since I just looked at 11, Might as well do 14. Do I really need to say anything about Final Fantasy 14? Yes, there is some controversy with Square and whatnot, but I still think this game is a bona fide slapper. I mean, it's got a new expansion, Dawn Trail, coming out soon. You bet I'm going to be binging that expansion. You know, like a kid binging, I'm not sure, a Milo Pony or something? Yeah. Yeah, I'm pretty much going to be doing with this game what bronies do to, you know, collect the Milo Pony series when they're feeling, you know, when they're feeling nostalgic. This game kicks ass. Yeah, it does have its problems. The late game grind can be a bit of a challenge if you want to get, you know, if you want to get all the best stuff, but you really don't need to. I mean, you could buy a bunch of 5-slot gear off the market board and use that, and you'll be perfectly fine. You'll easily be able to keep up with the people who have the top tier stuff. All the classes are a lot of fun to play. Some more so than others, but there's also some that are just completely broken, you know. Like the warrior, they're just completely broken in this game, so yeah. Plus the housing is a lot of fun, the roleplay community is really tight and active, so that's something to look forward to if you're bored. And the story is just crazy. Seriously. Some people say their bodies are made of a 70% movie. This game might as well be 70% movies. There's just so many cutscenes. Some of them dragging off for like an hour. But, well, that's how big and grand the story is. I mean, since when is Final Fantasy ever, you know, like ever, you know, piled off on its storytelling? I mean, seriously, do you ever played a Final Fantasy VII? So, yeah. Final Fantasy XIV, it's a damn good game. You know, at this point, even after everything they've done, I definitely trust Square more than I trust King's Isle, so Final Fantasy XIV, you're getting S tier. Plus, there's a lot of fans of this game, and I think if I gave this game anything lower than an S, I'll probably get flamed or something, and I don't want to deal, you know, with that bullshit, so. Ugh. Okay, I'm just gonna be blunt here. I don't even know if any of the Z Girls games count as an MMO. I mean, the second one kinda does, but it's more of like a survival simulation game. Pretty much a carbon copy of Last Day on Earth, except with cute, pretty much almost naked anime girls who lose all their clothes when they die for some reason. Yeah, this game in this series has always kind of rubbed me, you know, led the wrong way. I mean, I get what they were going for. They wanted a real-time strategy series with, like, set in the era of zombies and later robots with anime girls, but I think these games just missed the mark. And I think there's a reason nobody talks about them anymore. So yeah. Sorry, Z Girls, you had a fun nugget of an idea, but your downsides across your whole series just brings everything down. I'm not even sure if you count as an MMO, so yeah, why don't you go, chill out in the dumpster. Frickin' belong. World of Warcraft. I'm gonna be honest. I've hardly even played this game. Yeah, I know, that's crazy. I somehow managed to avoid World of Warcraft for the majority of my life. Seriously, until I was like 13 or something, I wasn't even aware of this game's existence. From what I understand, it's caused some unhealthy habits out there, so maybe it's best that I never played this thing. Not to mention, know. I don't think very highly of the company who made it anymore. I mean, I don't think anybody does at this point. I mean, Activision. Blizzard had some trouble on their hands before they merged into Activision. I don't think this whole micro-Blizz thing is going to be much better for them. By extension, it's not going to be much better for, you know, freaking WoW. I mean, I respect this game's legacy. It was the most popular game in the world for the longest time, and arguably still is today, although it really fights with Final Fantasy XIV for that title nowadays. This game has, you know, freaking WoW beat by a long shot, so I don't think it's safe to call WoW the most famous, like, MMO, like, anymore. Especially since they pushed out a handful of, controversial updates that, well, controversial that a lot of people didn't like. And not to mention the fact they tried to shut down a, you know, free legacy server that was up and going, which, you know, blew up in their face pretty bad, so. Yeah. World of Warcraft is still a solid game today. I think it's worth, you know, replaying if you're curious as to where, you know, like, MMOs really, you know, started to get famous, but nowadays, especially if you have access to Final Fantasy XIV, there's really not much reason to go back to it these days, so. Well, you are very much respectable, but I'm thinking of B tier. Yeah, sorry, WoW. Your faults are just enough to keep you down below A tier. Rift. This game is a pretty good. I mean, it's obviously not as good as it used to be. There's been quite a few controversial problems, you know, with this game over the years, but obviously, I haven't played too much of it myself. I played enough to give a solid opinion of it, but I think this game is still worth... I think the game's still worth checking out nowadays. It still has a pretty active player base, and the classes are a lot of fun to play. And but the story can just... it can really catch you off guard sometimes, so... Yeah. Rift, I don't have too much else to say about it aside from that. It's okay. It's worth coming back to if you're more a bitly curious, but apart from that, I think it gets a B tier. Yeah, there also seems to be a number of people who really don't seem to like it all that much, so they might get mad at me if I happen to rank it any higher, so... check it out if you're curious, but otherwise, I'd probably skip this and go play something in A tier or higher. Oh, RuneScape. I'm gonna be honest, this game completely, you know, skipped me over when it first came out and during its initial run. Granted, I was still a 6-year-old kid when this game first came out. Didn't really have access to a PC that had, an internet connection back then. So, and by, you know, like the time this game started really, you know, hitting its stride and, you know, becoming super popular and whatnot, I was too into the GameCube and like the PlayStation 2 to really care about freaking online games back then. And by the time online games did, you know, come into my life, Toontown and this game, Wizard, were pretty much, you know, I was pretty much all over those games, so it took all my attention. So RuneScape kind of got ignored by me during its initial run. I did check out its You know, I have, you know, checked out its remake, which this logo's from, and yeah, I think it's okay. I mean, obviously it's lacking a lot of, you know, it's lacking a lot of the, you know, of the detail that more modern, you know, modern games have, you know, including on mobile, but I still think it's a pretty good game. It's definitely worth, you know, checking out nowadays if you're curious about where, you know, MMOs like first, you know, got their start. So, you know, I don't know if RuneScape was the first MMO, but it came out in 2001, so it was definitely close. So, yep, you know, I'm thinking this game, boom, solid A tier because, you know, it is an OG and it's still worth playing nowadays. So, you should definitely check it out. Oh, Realms, how I miss you so. Again, I'm not completely sure if it counts as an MMO, but this game was just a bona fide slapper back in its days. You know, I haven't heard I haven't heard a whole lot of news about those remakes that they're supposedly making, but this game is still a lot of fun. You know, to read about, you know, look up articles about, listen to its soundtrack, and this game was a bona fide slapper back in the day. I really wish people would get with the program and just make a fan-made revival of it already. I mean, seriously, this game closed down like, I don't know how long ago, and there's still no news on that Free Realms Sunshine or Sunrise or whatever the heck it is, so. Yeah. Yeah. That game is still a bona fide slapper, though, so. I'm shoving it in A tier just for how fun it was. Rest in peace, you sweet prince. Maybe your time will come later. Oh, Genshin Impact. What needs to be said about this game? Again, not completely sure if it counts as an, MMO, but I'm counting it here because I really want to talk about this game. I haven't really played it in recent days because, you know, my time's been occupied with other things. I kind of, you know, dropped it and stopped playing it, but I think at some point in the near future, I will probably pick this game back up. Overall, it's a really good game. It's well made. It's fun to explore all the wide open areas. You know, a freaking Paimon is just a never-ending source of amusement. She always seems to make me laugh every single time that she's on screen. Well, this game has a pretty huge cast of characters who are, most of who are pretty well defined. There are a handful who could probably be handled a little bit better as far as the story goes, as far as their overall character development goes, but I still think it's a bona fide slapper of a game. Not to mention, it's got you know, one of the most active fan bases out there for a mobile, you know, MMO. So if I rate this any lower than S tier, folks will probably get shot or something. So, yep, I'm picking an S tier for Genshin. It does have its faults, like most other games do. It does have its downsides, but overall, it's still a solid experience. So I'll probably keep you busy for a while, even if some people accuse it of being a blatant knockoff of Breath of the Wild. Honkai Star Rail, well, I get that it exists, it's in the same universe as Genshin, and that it's, you know, fairly popular, you know, in its own right, but I haven't really sat down and put a lot of time into it. Most of my attention's been on Genshin, so, you know, if I had to pick any Hoyoverse MMO to play, Genshin's taken the bulk of my time compared to Honkai Star Rail, so I do think Honkai Star Rail is, you know, worth the time to play if you're really, you know, interested. You know, you're looking for something to play that, you know, that's in the same vein as Genshin, but otherwise, I don't know. I don't think there's much reason to, you know, play it over Genshin if you're already playing Genshin, so I'm thinking a rock solid A tier for that one. It is still a solid game, although it does have its downsides. I think they're more numerous than Genshin, but it's still a fun time. Ah, jeez. You know what, guys? I completely forgot about Reverse in 1999, even though I've been playing the heck out of this game as of late. Again, not entirely sure if it counts as an MMO, but I'm accounting this game as one because I really want to talk about it a little bit. Where do I start with this game? This one is just, whew, it is just crazy. I mean, where do I begin? The beautiful music, the incredible art style that looks like something ripped to look like something ripped straight out of a, I'm not sure what to compare it to. I'm not sure. Maybe something you'd see in a Beatles music like a video or something. But this game is just fun. I mean, the characters are all awesome. I mean, who doesn't love, like, a Sonetto, you know, like, the first, you know, usable unit that you get in the game? It's like, I'm sorry, if you don't like Sonetto, you are actually, like, immensely crazy or something. Yeah, you know what, the story's really interesting. I mean, the gameplay's a lot more, you know, relaxed than a lot of these other games, like, It doesn't demand too much of you. It's like something you can comfortably just have, you know, play in the background while you're doing something else. So, yeah. This game, despite being less than a year old, I think it's a bona fide slapper. That honestly, I'm really excited to see, like, I'm really excited to see where it goes from here. Cause, yeah, it's off to a strong start. It can only, you know, I'm assuming it can only get better from here. So, Reverse on 1999, you take your S tier and wear it proudly. Yeah. I guess that's it. That's all the MMOs that I've played or have experience with that I can form a solid opinion of. If I have to tier some noteworthy games that aren't on this list, you know, like the Ragnarok Online games, Neverwinter, you know, that sort of thing. Again, it's because I haven't played them whatsoever and don't really have enough experience with them to form a solid opinion. All these games I've pretty much known for a while now, and some of them I've been playing for a really long time, so I know a lot of these pretty damn well, especially Toontown and Wizard, so yeah. Overall, I think I'm satisfied with this. What about you guys? Where would you put these games? Like, what games would you stick on the list? What tier would they get, and why? Like, are there any good things about the game that justify a high tier? Or are there any, you know, things that bring the game down as a whole that would justify a much lower ranking? Let me know down in up the comments. Because I'm honestly, you know, interested to hear those opinions. Well, until next time, this has been your buddy Bulldozer Man, and I will see you later.